between Slashing Pumpkins in black and High Rollers in yellow. Pumpkins are unable to wear their beautiful, beautiful neon green shirts because of a jersey conflict with High Rollers, so they had switched to black. That is the advantage of being the better seed. So, got Andrew Nicholson here reffing, as well as Suds. And we have a very exciting game on our hands. Ball thrown in the zone. High Rollers looking to set the tempo up. We've got Jess here to help out with some names and faces.
Crazy Eights, not High Rollers.
Crazy Eights. Why did I say High Rollers? All right, so just ignore everything I just said. This is why Jason Stitch is so much better than me. He at least knows who he's calling. Ball thrown all the way down. Roderick is in net for the Slashing Pumpkins, and we have Pete in net for the Crazy Eights. All right, so Jess, you can help with some names and faces. I took some notes before the game, and we'll see if we can do it. We got on defense, we got Frank is going out there, and Sarah is also there as well. We have Emily on wing. I can't see who else we have.
That's Gaffey.
Gaffey.
And Sal.
Gaffey and Sal. Gaffey had scored last week, Jason said, so he is going to be a player to watch. Wins the faceoff. Ball kept in by the Slashing Pumpkins. Looking to set up. It's better there. Sal throws it. Could not get the clear. Ball kicked in. Big shot on net. Saved by Pete. And who took that shot? Was that Jenny?
I cannot tell.
Cannot tell. No, Jenny's wearing number 43, I guess. So that was not her. I'm doing my best
Kirsten,
here.
Then.
Kirsten. So.
Or Kirsten.
So the Crazy Eights were the number 2 seed, so they had a bye last week, and we saw the Slashing Pumpkins get a 2-1 win over Shut Your Five Hole. Get some pressure here by the Crazy Eights, dumping the ball in deep. Good keep in there, cutting off of the high board. Pumpkins able to clear it, not able to get out of the zone yet. Frank with a pinch, keeps it in. Sal picks up the ball. Jess, just correct me if I say any of the names incorrectly. Sal doing a good job there, trying to keep it in. Sal and Frank doing a battle against three, gets it back. They can't get it deep, but they're definitely keeping the ball in the zone, which is good. Frank with another keep in, shot on net. Saved by Roderick. Looked like he kind of lost it there, but he was able to hold on. That's some really good pressure there by Crazy Eights. I'm gonna say High Rollers about 30 times, so I apologize in advance. Jason Boyd going out there, looking to lead his team to victory. Jason gave me all the names and faces, so hopefully he was correct. Battle right there. It was Colin who picked it up. Clears it down. And that's Jenny going at it, so that's good. Ball carried in by Josh. Josh dumps it in. Saved by Eric. Bobbled a little bit, but he's able to gain control. So we've got exciting tap of games on today. I don't know what it means. Exciting number of games on tap. Excuse me. This is bright and early, and I am not a morning person, and I'm not a very articulate person, so see how it goes. Josh tries to take a shot on net. Josh to Colin. Ball dumped down, and that's going to be an icing. All the way down. So we've got some exciting games today. I'm going to be called by Tway, Jason Stitch, and I believe Josiah is actually going to be calling his first game, so we'll see how he does. But back to the game. I tried to keep in by Jenny. Could not be kept in. No, it was kept in. Right on the line. Chip Jason's got it. We've got a 3-on-2 forming. Big defense there by Josh. That is Rachel. Rachel battling for it. Chipped out by... not Kyle. Ugh. Trying. I'm going to focus more on the game and a little less on the names, and we will get a little assistance momentarily. So right there, the taller guy in the neon short shirt is Kyle. Emily is the girl right next to him, I believe,
right.
On the draw. That's correct, we got that. Ball thrown across. Collins going in, trying to battle for it. Centering pass. Going all the way down, I believe Phil missed it, but Phil is on his horse, gonna get down there. Battling hard. Getting a little chippy down there, a little physical, but it's all fair game in the playoffs.
Phil's really still, chippy.
That's Phil still battling for it. Everything's relatively clean. I believe that is, who's it, the tall guy for Slashing Pumpkins and Hell? Is that Ben?
Yes, that's Ben.
All the way down for icing. It's very hard to see these Pumpkins players because I'm so used to their neon green jerseys that it's definitely throwing me off a little bit. I'm unable to cheat having the names on the back. But we've got a back and forth game. Not too many shots on net. Both goalies tested once or twice. Seemed a little shaky on their first shot, but that's just going to be some early playoff jitters. I think in shots we'll probably have maybe one or two for both teams so far. Not much going on. Pumpkins keep it in. Yep. Big shot on net, saved by Pete. And who's the defender for Pumpkins who just took that shot?
That was Gavin with the shot from the point.
Gavin. Gavin, he had a really good game last week. I don't know if he scored or not, but he definitely is a very strong player. So on these faceoffs, someone better mark up on him big time. Shot on net, saved by Pete again. Scrum in front of the net. Pete with another save, still battling. Was that one of your cleanly won face-offs? So both teams kind of battled for it. It threw it on net, and they got 3-4 shots off right there. Pete able to hold his ground and keeping it 0-0 for the moment. Better change that Gaffe lineup for the draw. Jessica?
Oh, okay.
Is that Gaffe? Okay.
That is Gaffe.
Gaffe.
Gaffe's got the pants on.
He's got the pants on. He's also got a gigantic stick. Maybe it was just on the face-off, but it looked like that stick might need to be cut down a little bit. And we got Josh, throws it in the zone. Hand down by Gaffe. Picked up, thrown deep. A big keeper right there. I believe that's Tim. Nope. Trying. I'm gonna use.
Tim has the glasses. Yeah.
The one who looks like Adam right there. Who's running next to Sal, right?
Yeah.
I was correct. Okay, I was good.
Yeah.
I had talked to Adam Healy before the game. He gave me some names and faces, so hopefully I can remember them. Ball chipped in deep. We've got a real back and forth game. It seems like this is a real neutral zone back and forth battle. Neither team really able to set up and control. It's a big keeping right there. Thrown on net.
Oh.
Random deflection. Sale tries to throw it out. Big keeping by Jenny. Jenny tries to throw a shot, blocked by Gaffe. Throws it to Becca. Becca looks to carry. Jenny's on her. Becca, a nice little spin pass there. Oh. A little confusion there on the offside, but Pumpkin's able to keep it in deep. Shot on net by Pete. Second shot, save. Goal.
I guess Tim got it, but I'm not sure who the other player's name is who got the first shot on net.
It looks like it was Tim.
Kevin? Tim.
Tim scored.
Tim from Kevin, probably.
We have a jersey conflict right there. Saying that's green jersey on Colin, green jersey on Becca. So we're gonna see what's going on right now. But that being said, it's 1-0 Slashing Pumpkins after a goal by Tim. So we'll see how the Crazy Eight's able to respond. It was definitely a huge offensive. Little flurry right there by the Slashing Pumpkins. A couple keep-ins, a couple offensive zone draws, a lot of shots on net. And, if you crash in that, good things happen. And that's what happened. It took 4 or 5 shots. Ball thrown across.
Points wide open.
Points wide open. Big shot on net by Gavin. Could not hit the net. Could not find that corner. But Pumpkin's doing a good job keeping the pressure on. Icing is going to go all the way down. So I think the Pumpkins, you know, they're looking to really set the pace early on. You know, one goal, but you know, they're not dropping back. They're not trying to settle. They're going hard, trying to get the ball in deep and just crash the net again. For the Crazy Eights, I'm not sure what their plan is going to be. I think, you know, if they can try to dump the ball in, maybe just, you know, get a little offensive zone time of their own, that'd be great. A lot of the dump-ins have been going for icing. Jason wins that draw going against Gavin. Jason and Gavin in the corner. Jason traps it back in there. They're not going to battle. I think this is exactly what the Crazy Eights needed, just a little offensive zone time, feeling a little more confident, not having to worry about centering pass. Disconnected, goes pass over to Jenny for Slashing Pumpkins. Little bump there.
Yeah, a little rough.
It's getting a little physical there. Refs not going to make a call on that, but that's okay. Big keep in. Big chip across there on defense. Crazy Eights.
Yep.
Gain the zone, look to settle up. Jason goes to the slot. Picked off though. Ball gonna go all the way back. I believe that's Frank going back.
That's Josh from Crazy Eights.
Oh, that's Josh?
Looking, Josh on Crazy Eights, not Josh from Pumpkins. There's
Josh from Crazy Eights.
Yeah, I think he looks like Frank.
The problem is both Josh and Frank both wore helmets, so it's a little tricky there. Ball going all the way down. Josh with his very festive Halloween shirts.
It's appropriate for their team.
It is appropriate for the Slashing Pumpkins. He does have a very nice away jersey.
Mm-hmm.
Phil Glazer goes back with the ball, looks to set up, throws it all the way down, looks to hit Jason. Miscommunication because Crazy Eights were changing, and if Jason had touched that, that would have been a too many men penalty. Ball going all the way down. We got 3 minutes left in the first period. 1-0 for the Slashing Pumpkins. It looks like Beck has changed into a more yellow/neon shirt, so that will hopefully remove any confusion. Gaffey's out there, Phil Glazier. That is also Rachel. And I believe Colin for the Crazy Eights. Colin with a nice chip. Beats Jenny going all the way down. We got a 3-on-1 forming. Colin looks to pass it to Gaffey. Gaffey shot. Big saves by Roderick. Still loose.
Oh, wow. So many chances right there.
Ball dumped all the way down. We got offsides right now for Crazy Eights, looking to settle up. It's a very big chance right there. Ryder came up huge.
Yes, he did.
Becca looks to play. But big keep in right there. It'll scrum there. Phil tries to keep it in. Gaffey there behind him. Pumpkins push forward. Rachel tries to chip the ball out. The defense by four. Nothing going on right now, going back and forth. This is where the Slashing Pumpkins are gonna, you know, try to set the tempo. Ball goes all the way down. Shot. It's technically a shot on net. Roderick's gonna freeze it. That's a huge, huge plus for Crazy Eights right there because Pumpkins were starting to set up their offense in the zone. They start to crash in the net. And I think the Crazy Eights really need to keep the momentum off that last shift right there. A couple good chances. It was a 3-on-1 turn or 3-on-0. Two big saves by Roderick followed by a third.
That was huge. That was astonishingly well. It was like so good. That ball was gonna go in.
Yeah, Roderick, I mean, that's a big play. Ooh, that's a little chippy right there. Refs aren't blowing it. This game is getting a little aggressive.
Yeah.
That's a huge keep in right there by Sarah. Frank's got the ball, throws it across to Sale. Roderick decides to just chip it aside instead of freeze it. Sale picks up the ball. Go back and forth. Gavin tries to clear it. Gets by Frank.
That's Ben going in there.
Ben could not win the race, and Pete freezes it up. 30 seconds left in the first period. It's a very exciting game right now. Hopefully the teams are able to keep it up, and hopefully the game doesn't get a little too chippy. A little physicality we expect, but here we focus on safety and Gavin could not keep the ball in, goes all the way down, 15 seconds left. Looks like the Pumpkins gonna have one last chance. Throws it to Ben. Ben could not handle it. Ben is close to Tim. Misconnection goes all the way down. Pete's not gonna touch it. Frank's just gonna eat it.
Ice?
Ice.
Oh. That's a period anyway.
That's going to be a period right there. On that last call, I mean, it looked like it was a pass to Tim. He just couldn't handle it, but we're going to let that go. So thank you very much for watching. We have 1-0 Slashing Pumpkins at the end of the first. Crazy Eights wearing the yellow against Slashing Pumpkins wearing their away black jerseys. We have a 1-0 score right now, Slashing Pumpkins, goal by Tim. And we got a quick little second right there. Roderick's just flagging himself out. There, ball chipped in. Crazy Eights looking to set the tempo in the second period. Jason Boyd goes in, tries to make a play on that. Jason Emily trying to forecheck hard. Able to cause a turnover, could not get a shot on net though. Ball still in. Kind of a little tic-tac back and forth. Trying to chip it out. Jenny bats it down. Shot blocked. Jason gets a shot at. Goal by Jason Boyd. Looks like Josh got in front of it, batted it down, went right to Jason's stick, was able to backhand it in. And now that is 1-1 right there. And that's exactly what Crazy Eights needed. I think the Pumpkins came out very strong in the first period, put a lot of pressure on. It was one or two chances for Crazy Eights, but that was definitely Slashing Pumpkins first. Jason Boyd sets the tempo for the second period. Goal against Roderick. We have 1-1 and we've got a game forming right here. Ball battle in front of the net. Shot by Becca. Dumped out by Josh. Looks like Frank almost had a stick on it. We're gonna have no icing here. Frank chips it down to Rachel. Rachel to Becca. Becca looks up. That's a very good forecheck by, I believe, Adam Healy. Chipped out to Jason. Jason looks to throw it to Becca. Misconnection there. Josh pitchforks it back in. Shot on net goes wide. Battle, ooh, looks like someone stepped on his stick. We have a penalty here. Uh-oh. No, looks like she's okay. A little scary right there. Tripping on Josh, so the ball is gonna go in the offensive zone. Slashing Pumpkins looking to score a goal right here. Sud's giving a call, 2 minutes for Josh for tripping. It looked a little dangerous, but glad no one was hurt. Slash Pumpkins look to go 2-1. They got Gavin at the point. They got Jenny lining up on right wing. Gaffey tries to win that draw. Becca tries to clear it. Gavin's stick is a little too short right there. Could not get that. So we on the penalty kill, we got Becca. We've got Gavin. Excuse me, Gaffey. Gavin with the ball for the Slashing Pumpkins. Phil Glazier's out there. And on defense, we also have Sarah trying to kill his penalty. Sarah goes in deep. Ball trying to go around the net. Semi wrap around, grabbed by Pete. It's gonna be a stick side draw right there. And Rachel is going to replace Sarah right there. On this penalty kill, big win by Gaffey, cannot get it out. Becca does her job, trying to crash the point. Scrum there. Gavin unable to get to it again. Pumpkins are having a hard time keeping it in the zone, and this is going to definitely eat a lot of their valuable time. Gavin's going to carry it in, tries to throw a shot on net. Phil steers it wide. Gaffey gets the ball, dumps it all the way down. Crazy Eights doing a really good job killing this penalty right here. Gaffey looking to come off and change. Gets off right there. Rachel's got the ball, she's just gonna set up, takes her time. She's in no rush on the penalty kill. And Becca's there to help out on the half board. Becca tries to get it out, cannot. Ball chipped in deep, gonna go batted all the way down. Crazy Eights doing just a very good job on this penalty kill right now. Pumpkins are having a hard time trying to capitalize, they just gaining their zone is tricky. Gavin's gonna carry the ball in himself. Looks to throw it in deep. 10 seconds left in the power play. But Josh forechecking aggressively right there. Looks a centering pass, blocked. Joss throws it, cannot get across. Gavin with the ball. Oh, that's a very unlucky bounce right there. Gavin tries to clear it, but cannot. Collin came out of the penalty box. Did not commit the penalty, but he's the next forward up. Becca tries a centering pass right there. We're going to have a penalty on Josh. It's going to be a slash or over the top. Not sure what they're going to call. Yep, 2 minute slash on Ben right there. I think I was calling him Josh a second ago. Not sure why. But that's okay. Now we have a very important power play here. If the Crazy Rage are able to score, they'd really be able to take this game over right now. You know, they're definitely putting the pressure on this second period. Even though there was a penalty that kind of set them back a couple minutes, they did a very good job killing it. Centering pass, big goal right there. Emily lets it rip, big pass from Collin, throws it across. That is why you have to put a body on that person in the slot. You lift the stick, do whatever you can. That's a huge goal by Emily right there. Gonna take control of the game right now. Crazy Eight up two. Gets the Slashing Pumpkins who have one. Very pumped. It's a very good one-time shot right there. Jenny chips it across in deep. Now, let's see how the Slashing Pumpkins are able to reset and try to take control. Big shot turned aside by Pete. Pumpkins looking to try to get it in deep and set up right now. Big keep in. Big goal! Josh responds with a huge goal right there. Big keep in. Crazy Eight's unable to keep it out of the zone. Josh kept it in. Able to let it rip. Goes glove side right over Pete's shoulder. Yep, I got it. 8 minutes, 40 seconds left. This has become a very different game than the first period. Both teams coming out scoring very quick goals. And this offensive flurry might just continue. This might be a 4-4-5-5 game or something along those lines. Very even match. Gavin throws it all the way across. Raved off. Frank was able to get to it, and he does. Frank's looking to set up. Throws it across. Gavin with the pickoff right here. Gavin carries it in deep. Tries to pitchfork it. Unable to get it through. Ball thrown across. Pumpkins keeping the ball in, just trying to set up. This is exactly where the Pumpkins are the most dangerous. If they're able to, yep, Gavin with another keep in. Another shot on net. Ball kicked out, no one able to get to it. Thrown all the way down there. Emily's gonna ice it down there, just let the Crazy Eight reset. It looks like, in all honesty, it seems like Gavin's just doing a very good job keeping the ball in. Maybe they wanna, if the Crazy Eights have a chance, they try to throw the ball to the other side. Gavin's doing a very good job keeping it in, causing a lot of pressure, and you know, if you're not able to clear the ball, Pumpkins are really gonna set you. This is their bread and butter right there. Get the ball in deep, set up. Big win by Gaffey. Battle behind the net. Throwing all the way out. Kept in. Gaffey, carrying it, got some nice stick in. Fortunately lost it at the line. Gavin battled for it. Ball out of the zone right there. Really good pass. Gaffey was off for a second. Gets back on. Emily throws to Gaffey. Sale gets a shot. Big save. Full Sale. Roderick made the first save, made the second save. Everyone got through him. Sale's pumped right now. Crazy. Sale says, let's go. Very, very big goal right there. Crazy Eight's able to gain the lead again. For the first time, I believe. It's back and forth game right now. Gaffey kicks the ball in deep. Emily on her horse trying to get to it. Ben tries to throw it across. Jenny ends up beating Frankie to it. After a nice battle, I believe it was Frank. You cannot tell. Both the defensemen were the same thing. That was not Frank. Apologize. Jason carries it in. Shot on Roderick. Save. Ball going in deep. Pumpkins looking to get the ball out. Throws it to Ben. Kept in. Jason shot steered wide. I think if I'm the Crazy Eights, just a little more zone time trying to you know, keep the momentum in your favor.
Stick on them, Jimmy. Stick on.
A lot of scores here. I don't think anyone scored two. We've got five goals from five different goal scorers right now. Ball a little physical. Gaffey bumped off. Able to control. Shot on net. Blocked by Josh. Ball carried. Huge keep in there by Rachel. Rachel playing a very good game right now on defense. Ball pitchforked into Jason. Misconnection, but Jason's able to win the race to get to it. Jason battling down low. Spin move. Carries it in. Shot on net. Speared wide. Emily gets there. Looks at centering pass. Going all the way across. She's a crazy from the ball back and forth. She's trying to make a connection. Ball goes to Gaffey. Gaffey's got Emily wide open. Emily with a backhand. Unable to score. Unable to get it on net. That's okay. Ben trying to get it out. Very good defense there by Rachel. Still has not gotten out of the zone. Rachel put a lot of pressure on there. Very good. Gaffey battling. Phil Glazer throws it to Emily. And looks to carry it. Flips it in there on Roderick. Ball falls over. Gaffey gets it. Jason shot. Good wide. Really good play by Emily there. Uh-oh. Emily got hit. Little stinger right there. She's tough and she'll be fine. I think it was, Phil tries to keep it in. Out. Yeah, it's going to go off. It's going to go offsides because Emily was able to get off. So it'll shake it up after the ball hit her, I believe, in the arm. But back to that play, I feel like Emily did a really good job just unsure what to do it. She kind of chipped it on net. Landed in an awkward place. Roderick didn't want to freeze it, didn't want to steer it aside, so it kind of kicked out. And Gaffey took a quick run to the net, and it was a very good scoring chance. I think if the Crazy Eights are able to just keep putting the pressure on like this, I think it'll be their game right now. Ball chipped aside to Becca. Adam gets it. That might have been a hand pass, not sure on that, but refs might have missed it, might have seen it, not sure. Offsides. Ball frozen by Pete. Very rough couple minutes right there. Semi-hand pass, unsure. Has some offsides right there. A lot of confusion, but refs are going to sort it out, and I believe it'll be a draw outside of the zone. Nope, saying it's all the way down because it was frozen by Pete. No one was technically offside. The shot was not on net. So, waved off. Face off one. Colin going for it. Gavin tries to keep it in. Ooh, he had it for a second. Just could not control it. Got Jenny across, but he throws it to Ben. Ben looks to make a nice pass to Adam in front. Could not connect. Ball chipped in. Battling for it. Gavin chips to Jenny. Jenny chips to Ben. Ben gains his own. Looks to go inside, outside against Becca. Does. Shot on net. Blocked by Phil. Phil tries to clear it, but Jenny's able to keep it in. Throws it to Ben. Ben shot. Ends up on Becca's stick. Becca going to throw it all the way down. Gavin gets to it again. Big keep in by Gavin. Becca tries to clear it out again. Crazy. It's looking to gain the zone right there. Chipped in. Gavin's going to be the first to it. We're going to see what he does with it. Goes all the way around. Not much pressure. A little slow. No icing. Phil Glazer contest it. We got Pumpkins looking to reset. Trying to set up their offensive zone. It's been very successful in the last two goals. Shot on net. Little high. Pete able to get a glove on it, but not able to control it. Ball kicked out. Jenny gets to it. Shot on net. Does not get through. Hit a foot, I believe. Becca tries to clear it. Big keeping. Second big keeping. Shot blocked right there. Ball dumped in. Looks like Colin and Gavin are going to go for it right now. Very close race. A little physical, but that's a nice friendly battle right there. Gavin's able to win it. Looks to carry it out. Carries it. Hits Adam going across the middle. We got a penalty here on Crazy Eights. Becca's going to touch it up, and that will be a penalty. High stick for Slashing Pumpkins there. And this is a reminder for anyone watching, the DCHL rule for delayed penalties. Your goalie does not have to leave. The goalie does not have to leave the crease. All he has to do is just stay there, and you can send another player out, making sure you keep in mind the two female rule at all times. The goaltender is just not allowed to play it, not allowed to make a save, and it's just treated as though the goalie is effectively invisible. A lot of confusion here right now. They're going to call Emily off. I believe the penalty was on a female player, so they're able to have three men out there. So, shot on net, steered aside by Pete. Tried to chip out. Battle for it. Sal gets it. Tries to clear it. Kept in. Pumpkin's looking to settle up right here. Good forecheck. Pumpkin's with a big keep in. Shot on net. very ticky-tack going back and forth. Unable to clear it, though. KZ stuff it all the way down left over for Nyssen because they are on the short hand. Pumpkins looking to carry it. Josh carries it. Looks to make a play. Big play by Sale, keeping it out. Crazy Ace looking to carry it in. Shot on net, steered wide. It's very scary here. Crazy Ace putting a lot of pressure on. Pumpkins unable to really gain the zone right now. Another shot on net, steered aside by Roddick. Josh gets the ball. Looks to flip it across, block. Pumpkins throw it back to Josh to gain the zone. This is exactly what they needed. Get the ball in deep, try to set up, and that is the end of the second period. Second period, we had some goal by Sale, goal by Emily, and a goal by, I believe, Josh. And that will be 3-2 right now at the end of the second period. Crazy Eights. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the third. Welcome back for an exciting third period between the Crazy Eights in yellow and the Slashing Pumpkins in their away black jersey. At a penalty at the end of the period, so Crazy Eights are going to start shorthanded. Crazy Eights looking to dump it. Jason gets the ball, loses his feet, still battling for it, chips it in deep. This is exactly what the Crazy Eights need to do, just get the ball in deep. Force a turnover and just try to kill this penalty right now. Ball kicked aside by Roderick. Gavin gets the ball. I think Gavin's gonna do a very good job gaining the zone, hopefully. Throws it in deep. Crazy Eight try to clear it. Kept in by Jenny. Jenny battling for it. Gaffey gets the ball. Chips it all the way down. And this is exactly what Crazy Eight need to do to kill the remaining seconds on their penalty. Gavin tries to throw it to Ben. Misconnection, that's going to go icing all the way down. So Crazy Eight's going to be full on the drop, so it's a very important face-off win. We'll see what happens. Crazy Eight's a 2-seed, doing a very good job against the Slashing Pumpkins, who had won last week against Shut Your Five Hole. A very good 3-2 game, we're not sure where it's going. Adam Healy lining up for the draw. Very important draw right now. Chip back in deep. Now Emily comes in and Crazy Eights are full. Jason Boyd with the ball looking to settle up. Emily's wide open in the slot. Adam crashes in on her before she's able to get a shot. Jenny gains the ball, tries to get it out. Nice battle. Jenny still controls it. Two on her right now. Jason's able to keep it in. Drop back, shot blocked by Gavin. Gavin chips it over to Pumpkins gain the zone. Adam gets the ball, tries to throw it on net. Another shot blocked. Crazy Eights doing a good job keeping the ball out of the slot, keeping the ball out of pizza area of influence, I guess. Ball frozen by Pete, and we are going to have another draw here. Slashing Pumpkins are going to look to settle up. With 13 minutes left, I think they got more than enough time to score. Both teams showing they're capable of scoring goal on the power play or uneven strength, so we will see. Adam Healy takes the draw, wins it back. Big keeping, Josh has it. Blocked by Colin. Another shot on net. Pete with another save. So I think very important for the Crazy Eights to get out there. Josh has scored one of the goals for the team, so if he can get a shot from the point, he might score again, you never know. I believe he beat Pete on the Pete glove side shoulder. Ball to him again. Josh throws it across. Very good pass. Misconnection right there. Throwing across. Emily's able to jump the pass. Chips it across to Colin. Colin makes a play. Four of the Slashing Pumpkins there to control it. Very good on the forecheck right there. Don't want to give up another goal here. Can't afford to with just under 12 minutes to play in the third period. Very good pass across. Phil Glazer, Adam Healy going at it. Adam's moving fast. Phil takes it across, throws it to Becca. Back to Phil. Phil tries to throw it to Colin to clear it. Colin picks up the ball. We got a 2-on-3 going. Colin looks to throw it across to Emily. Kind of went inside to take a shot, could not get to it. Ball tripped across, kept in by Becca. All the way in. Josh picks up the ball. Misconnection there, ends up on Emily's stick. Emily looks to settle up. Very good pass. Colin calling for it. Shot on net, steered aside by Roderick. Josh gets the ball again. Looks to chip it all the way across. Phil's able to get to it, but he gained the zone. Pumpkins having a hard time controlling the zone. They did very good in the first and second period. That's how they led to the goal. Just get the ball in the zone, throw it across. Ball kicked out by Phil. Ball's out, Colin picks it up. Oop, looks like Colin lost his footing. Not sure if he stepped on a stick or the ball or not, but glad he's all right. Phil gets the ball again. Pitchforks it all the way out. Pumpkins are offsides, look to throw it across. Adam and Becca going at it. Becca throws it all the way down. Gavin's gonna settle up. Emily's going hard. Emily with a very good forecheck right there. Kicked across. Phil's able to jump the route. That's the forecheck by Emily. Able to cause that. Pumpkins having a hard time getting his own silk. Gaffey picks the ball up. Tries to throw it across. Ends up on Gavin again. Gavin makes a play on Sale. Chips it all the way down. Chipped in at the line. Phil tries to throw it to Gaffey. Hits him in the foot. Goes all the way back and forth. We got a lot of ping pong going right now. No one's really able to set it. Big turnover right there. Phil. Right there, tries to chip it out. And that comes Slashing Pumpkins. Very good chances right there, unable to score. Unfortunately, they're going to be kicking themselves for that, but the ball is going to go all the way down. All the way down for icing. Seth had a nice chance there, was unable to capitalize. Big save by Pete. Defense for Crazy H responded, and we're unable to keep the. I'm going to shut up. That was a broken sentence. I apologize. Gaffey takes the draw, tries to kick it across to Sale. Shot on net, steered aside. Pumpkins able to set up right now. Rolls out, big shot on net. Pete with a save. Rebound kicked out. Gaffey crashes, trying to keep it out. Ball dumped all the way. It's not going to go for icing. Pumpkins really wanted to keep in right there, but unable to do so. Pumpkins doing a quick little line change. Looking to set up, carrying the ball down. Tim carries it, looks to throw it across to Josh. This is what they need right now. Big defense, a little bit of a trip there. Yep. Referee Suds gonna wave it. I believe he's gonna get tripping right there. Could be on Frank. Officially a hold that caused a trip on Frank. I'm going to give myself credit for calling the trip right there, but I think this is going to be a very important power play here for the Slashing Pumpkins. Gavin's on the point. Adam's going to take the draw. Jenny's going to hopefully be crashing the net. Ben's going to be out there trying to just let it rip from the high slot. Pumpkins trying to push the ball. Adam and Gaffey battling hard for it. Crazy 8's able to get the ball, try to clear it. Ball's going to go down. Gavin's going to gather it, try to reset. Emily very hard on that forecheck. He's playing a very good game. Ball kept in by Ben. Emily blocked it and chips it all the way out right there. Ben gets the ball, throws it in. Crazy, it's going to throw it all the way down again. Pumpkins are having a hard time getting in the zone right now. Gavin's going to throw it in right now. Adam's going hard, going to try to put a little pressure in. And it's going to be out again right now. I think the Pumpkins really got to carry the ball in. I think the little jump and chase is not going to work. Ball's going in again, tipped all the way up. Emily goes hard, battles for it, throws it across. Gavin picks it up, but Emily's going to forecheck hard again. Emily stifling Gavin right now. This is a huge problem for the Slashing Pumpkins. Emily did a very good job right there. Ben picks it up, throws it on the net. He kicks it aside, does not freeze it. Gavin with the ball, throws it on net. Goes wide. Ben battling for it. Insanely good defense right there. Rachel's doing a good job, just keeping the ball kind of hemmed in right there. Adam gains the ball. Going to Gavin. Gavin puts a shot on net, goes wide. Tipped out, Adam with the ball again. Back-hand shot. Keeps steers to the side. Ben battling for it. All the way out. Jenny's going to try to keep the ball in. Gavin's going to be at the point trying to keep it in right now. Turnover. Ben picks it up. Going to Gavin gains the ball. Shot on net. Big save by Pete, steered wide. No one was there at the back door to get a rebound. Very exciting power play for the Pumpkins, unable to capitalize. Honestly, I think the huge play right there was Emily did a very good job with a forecheck with her players. Very good defense on her part. You know, she was in the high slot, prevents the centering pass. That was honestly one of the best shifts I've seen on a player in a penalty kill in a long time. Penn gets the ball down there. Emily's on her. Emily did a very good job just keeping Ben from doing anything with it. She gains the ball, carries it. Little flips pass, ends up going to Gavin, but all she needed to do was clear the zone and let the big change by the Crazy Ix. And we're gonna have a too many players on the floor. I believe it was Rachel who played that. We're gonna have Jason serve it on the Jason serve it on a too many men play. I think if everyone's fresh, I would. Based on that last play, I would have definitely taken Emily on that, but unnecessary. In that case, we got Phil and Becca out there. Emily's gonna kill it again. It's gonna be a long shift for her, so this is gonna be a player to watch right now. If she stands tough and you know keeps her forecheck up, keeps her plays going, that'll be good. But you know if she tires out or something, that might result in a you know effective 5-on-3 for the Pumpkins right now. The timeout by the Pumpkins. We got 5:38 left in the third period right now. Yeah, I think the player to watch right now it's going to be Emily on defense, and we've got I think Seth and Josh are going to be huge right now to score. Josh scored earlier, and we'll see if he's going to be able to score again right now. Sud's saying Seth is out for not scoring up on the draw, so we're going to drop it again. Oh, Crazy Eights win the draw, able to get it all the way down. Shot deflected, very good. Just remember, this is a Slashing Pumpkins power play, so Seth gets the ball, looks to, very good forecheck, Phil fans on it though. Ball goes in deep. Pumpkins really need to score on this. If they don't, I think this might be game right now. You know, it is possible to score in the last couple minutes, but this is gonna be their best chance right now. Seth gets the ball, defense by Phil. Phil making sure not to wrap up. Seth feels kind of hemmed in right there. Ball cleared out, goes to Josh. Josh lets it rip. Big glove save by Pete right there. I think the Crazy Eights are gonna be sacrificing their point coverage to try to battle down low. I think Josh is gonna be open for this. It looks like Jenny's also gonna be out there on the point. So we got two good point shooters here for the Pumpkins. If they're able to get the ball, it's gonna be very, very important for them just to, Josh gets it, looks to set up. Jenny was covered. Big shot blocked by Pete. The defense did a very good job taking off the pass across to Jenny. Phil tries to clear it. Cannot. Big block by Gaffey. Another shot on net. Blocked it. Gaffey doing a very good job killing this penalty. Looks like he's going to dump it all the way down. Gaffey's going to win this to himself. Roderick does not freeze it. Gaffey gets the ball. Jenny trying to D up. Seth and Becca battling down low. Seth gets it. Nope. Big goal. Oh my gosh. Seth was going for it. Becca chips it to Gaffey on that, and Gaffey gets the goal shorthanded. Very good effort by both Becca and Gaffey to get the ball out there. Dump it in. I mean, Gaffey got the ball, chipped it in deep, battled hard for it, throws it across. Becca and Seth, you know, battle for it. Becca was able to chip it to Gaffey. Gaffey lets it rip, beats Roderick down low. It's going to be 4-2 for Crazy Eights. And now we have it will be a penalty. Any icing call on the Crazy Eights will be penalty. Phil Glazier tries to clear it. Gavin's able to keep it in. Gavin makes a move on Gaffey. Carries it across. Oh, this one might have a high stick there on Gavin. Gaffey's going to throw it all the way down. Uh-oh. Big breakaway here by Colin. Goes inside out, beats Roderick, but cannot find the net. And Gavin touches it up, and we have a high stick on Gavin with 3 minutes left. And that penalty should be the end of the game right here. 3 minutes left, there'll be two on the penalty. So unless the Slash Pumpkins are able to break one out and score shorthand, this might be a game-ending play right here. I think if I were the Pumpkins, I'd be really looking to settle up in defensive zone, try to throw a breakout pass, and just beat them on a breakaway. They've got some very fast players. This is very important. Draw. One to Colin. Colin's shot on net, deflected. Colin drops it back. Adam gets the ball, tries to clear it. Little ping-pong and back and forth. Josh gets the ball, tries to settle up. Colin with a slow forecheck. Colin's in no rush. They don't need to score. Josh takes it out. This is going to be dangerous right here. He makes a move. He's going to create a little bit of offense right now. Adam's going to the net. Josh settles up. Colin throws it across. Centering pass. Adam cannot get a stick on it. Jenny keeps it in to Adam. Emily battles hard for it, keeps it out, pushes it to Colin. And now we got a breakaway for Colin right here. Not really a breakaway, could not get all of it. Shot steered wide. Really good pass by Emily. She's unable to, ball goes all the way down. Emily, very nice little chip pass. Colin just could not get that separation. Also, if I were the crazy hits right now, I wouldn't be looking for anything too crazy, unlike their namesake. Just get the ball in deep and make the Pumpkins attack you. Colin going hard for the ball. Colin wins it. Battle. Emily chips it, tries to chip it past to Colin. Cannot. Jenny picks it up. Carries it down. We have 2-on-2 forming. Jenny lets it rip. Blocked it by Sarah. Throwing all the way down. Will not go for icing. Battle there. Kept in by Emily. Emily gets the ball. Sets up. Shot on net. Big glove by Roderick. With the penalty expires at 49 seconds. Emily with another play right here. This is a very strong game on her part. I think she might be the player of the game in my book right there. Big goal, very big penalty kill. Very strong passing. I don't know, for player of the game, I think she might be a very strong contender. Crazy Eights line up. Jason Boyd chips it across to Becca. Becca's gonna carry it down low. Going all the way across. Ball battling right there. Rachel wins the draw, wins the race, tries to throw it out. Her and Ben battling down low. Extra attacker out for Slashing Pumpkins. Death chance to throw that, just could not get it past Pete's head.
Double team that!
The battle, Gaffney's feet, he's gonna throw it all the way down. It's not gonna go for icing. Actually, it's going on net. Wow, what a goal. That is insane. Gaffey scores an empty net goal, making it 5-2 Crazy Eights at the very tail end of the third period. So for that, we have 5 for Crazy Eights, 2 for Slashing Pumpkins. Thank you for joining us, and have a wonderful rest of your day.
We'll do it all. Before we get too old, show me. waste time chasing cars around our heads. I need your grace to remind me to find my own. If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world? Forget what we're told before we get too old. Show me a garden that's bursting into life. Just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?